This week, I've been speaking to you about how the left is a cult, expecting their constituencies to embrace woke nonsense, which always flies in the face of truth and reality. They make things up to further a narrative and smear those who dare to speak the literal truth. And boy, do I have a perfect example for you tonight. Some on the left clutched their pearls and got mad at my noting last night that Joe Biden inserted a word into the Declaration of Independence that the founders did not write.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all women and men are created equal, endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights, among them life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Democracy doesn't happen by accident. We have to renew it with each generation.
All righty, notice how we added women and men are created equal, not just men. It matters, right? That's not what the founders wrote. Apparently, the sacred words of our founders weren't inclusive enough for Sleepy Joe. Yeah, there you go. The left's response was totally predictable and pathetic. Here's a sample. Right-wing influencers like Tammy Bruce do so much fetishizing of the Constitution and the founding fathers that Fox News is basically just baby boomer rage porn. It would be sad if it wasn't so dangerous. Well, those pearls are crushed into dust. The ultimate reaction of a cult rage of a cult is rage at a contradiction or a truth that runs counter to their narrative moment. So here's a newsflash for the left. Gay, straight, feminist, or whatever minority group you've arbitrarily co-opted. You don't get to make things up to suit your narrative. You don't get to pretend grifters and hoaxers are heroes, or rapists and abusers are feminist standard bearers. You don't get to gaslight the American public that the economy is just fine, or that people who vote differently than you are terrorists, or that Democrats are champions of the marginalized. Joe Biden has a history of taking other people's words and changing them just a bit to make it seem like they're his, or in this case, to pander to a political narrative, and that has always been unacceptable. The fact is, this country was born imperfect, like all of us, and we make changes and grow into a more perfect union, made possible only because of the genius of the founders and of our founding documents, allowing this greatest nation on earth, in fact, to exist. Especially for those of us who are minorities, we become a better nation not by changing what was written or melting down statues or destroying people's lives. We change it through elections, law, and legislation. I've been an advocate for women most of my adult life. All of the civil rights movements in this country were to allow us to be ourselves, to not have to pretend in order to placate someone else. And now, ironically, it's the left attacking those who do not conform or who refuse to bend a knee to prescribed woke garbage. What an abandonment of all civil rights movements, and what a travesty. So here we are. We got a few words to those of you who attack people who dare to be different or who don't follow your corrupt and abusive rules. Grow up, snap out of it. You're in a cult. This is not what personal freedom looks like. It is what totalitarianism looks like. It is what we used to reject and what, fortunately, what most of us continue to fight.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.